Six inspiring women who have made their mark in shaping Arizona history are being honored this week at the third annual Arizona Latina Trailblazers event presented by Latino Perspectives Magazine and the Raul H. Castro Institute at Phoenix College. With me to talk about these women are Rosa Cays, editor of Latino Perspectives Magazine, and Arizona State Senator Olivia Cajero Bedford. The senator and her mother, Carmen, are being honored at the event. Thank you both for joining us on Horizonte. Rosa, give us a little bit of the history of the event. I think this is the third year.
Yes, this is the third year that Latina Trailblazers are being honored, and this is the third volume. A publication accompanies the event and covers the history of these women. Biographies written by Dr. Christine Marin, ASU's historian and archivist. And the event is this year, was held at Phoenix Art Museum, and basically just shares the history of Arizona women, Latinas, who have helped shape what we have today as far as civil rights, education, healthcare, things like that.
Mm-hmm. And there's a special aspect to this year's crop because it has some connection with the Arizona Centennial.
Yes. The theme for this year is Our History is Our Strength. So, and then the Latina Trailblazers are honored in March because of National Women's History Month. So that all kind of goes hand in hand. So.
Now we've got some very prominent women, two of whom have passed on, but we'll be showing the pictures of some of them as they come up, and we'll mention them as we go through. But Senator, you are one of two mother-daughter teams, so to speak, who will be honored. And this first picture we have up here is, well, is that your mom there? Well, that's you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think that was your mom before. But
with the white hair.
Yes. Tell us a little bit more about your mom.
My mom served for 24 years. She took over after my dad died. My dad was...
When you say took over, she took out his legislative position.
She took over his position, right. He died in office in his fifth year. He was in the House of Representatives. And then she was appointed to fill his position. And she ran for 11... She ran 11 more times and served for 24 years. And then during that time, the family, me included, used to help her with her campaigns. And politics was always a part of our life.
And then you ran and have served, 9 years now?
This is my ninth year. I've served 8 years in the House, and I was just elected to the Senate this past fall. So I'm starting 9 years. So Cajero has been at the legislature for 38 years, has been a part of the legislature.
And a part of Arizona history, as Rosa was talking about, which is why you're being honored. You also are good friends and knowledgeable of one of the other honorees, Mary Rose Wilcox.
Yes, I love Mary Rose Wilcox. She's just right there in the middle of good fights, and she stands up for what she believes, and I just have such high regard for her.
And we've got her picture on the screen right now as we're talking about
her. She's wonderful. She is really an asset to her constituents.
Now, the process that Latino Perspectives goes through, Rosa described it a little bit. She talked about Dr. Marin's work in developing information. She came up with some stuff that surprised you.
Right. The research that was done for this project by Latino Perspectives Magazine was very impressive, because I was called and told that I had, and my mother, were being honored, but after, and they told me to review some material about our family, but when I saw it, I had no idea what had been going on. They had started the research last year. I was notified the end of January, but they had started the research last year. What I found from their research, that not only had my grandfather come from Mexico, but his father had come also. I didn't know that until I read the research.
And there was also some information about some of the discrimination that your family members ran into.
That's right.
In southern Arizona.
My grandfather and great-grandfather were recruited by the mines in Morenci to work. and they were happy to have the jobs in the mines. But I learned from this research that there was two pay scales. There was a pay scale for white workers, and there was a pay scale for Mexican workers. And I didn't know that. And, you know, 100 years later, there's still some of that happening today. I don't want to quite, you know, but we're fighting the immigration bills 100 years after my immigrant grandparents came. And here I am, just last week, dealing with the immigration issue.
And I want to talk some more about that, because
sure,
it's not just an important part of your story, but as you point out, it's what's going on right now. And Rosa, does that make it any more important at this time in our state's history, given all the turmoil and this anti-immigrant sentiment that seems to be sweeping our state, to have this kind of an event?
Absolutely, I think so. To acknowledge the fact that Arizona was not, you know, white people alone building what it is today. You know, if you go back in history and you know, as her father came to work in the mines, and, you know, who was here first? I mean, I think when I even start talking about the whole immigration thing, it gets me heated up, because Arizona's history is based in, you know, a lot of Latinos, Hispanic people coming here and creating homes and building infrastructure and having it be part of what it is now. I mean, my own family, I'm first generation, and Arizona is home, even though they came here from Mexico. And so for me, yeah, it's definitely worth acknowledging these women and the trails that they've blazed for the rest of us.
And probably even more important to focus on Latinas, because their story is even more hidden.
Correct.
Than that of other Latinos who've contributed to Arizona history.
Yes, well, the impetus for for acknowledging Arizona Latinas is that the executive editor of Latino Perspectives has a background in education. And when she started looking for information on women in Arizona, she couldn't find anything.
And we're talking about Dr. Cecilia Rosales.
Correct. Mm-hmm. And so it was her idea, and I'm not sure exactly who she approached first or how it all actually started, but she was definitely, it was her idea to get things going and put some books out there in the libraries so, you know, future generations can learn about these women.
And one of those women, as we've noted, was your mother. If she were with us today, I realize she passed on a few years ago, what would she be saying about what's going on these days at the legislature, which is an institution she served in for so many years?
She would be in there fighting, you know, very, very, very hard, because she was the daughter of immigrants, you know, and she wound up having a good life, you know, and she realized the importance of education. She saw how her parents had worked so hard, had struggled so hard. And when she and my dad went to school in Morenci, they spoke Spanish. And during that time, the teachers would hit their hands with a ruler because they were speaking Spanish. And so when I was born, they made sure that I only spoke English. So I spoke English before I spoke Spanish. But she would be working. She would be fighting and be very, very mad. My mother could be so mad. She's a nice, sweet, white-haired lady, but she could be so mad. It was like, look out.
Well, I'm sorry we don't have her around, not only to provide leadership but to be a guest. But thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And Rosa, thank you, and thank you to Latino Perspectives.